I am back with a new video, and this is another video about fake spirit guides, tricksters, and demons. And it's important to remember that they are low vibrational beings that are great in shape-shifting, and that they are hard to recognize, even though a lot of mediums and psychics and healers like to think otherwise, but they are great shapeshifters, so it's not that easy to really feel that their energy level is different than from a real angel or a pet servitor or a passed away grandmother or grandfather or an ascended master or something like that. When you contact or made a connection with a trickster, demon, or a fake spirit guide, you often are presented with a certain time frame, time, date, year, things like that. And ascended masters and real angels and things like that don't work with time. So that's a very important clue to keep in mind. As soon as you hear, I will get this phone call within a week, then it's a fake spirit guide or whatever. Another thing is that when the session or whatever is over, you feel disconnected from your body or dizzy or tired or not really well grounded or things like that. So that's another thing. Time and feeling disconnected from reality. And tired and exhausted and disorientated and things like that. Another thing is that they like to give you the answer that you're looking for. They want you to believe that they are high spiritual beings and that they have great wisdom and are enlightened and that they know the future, the past, and the present, and that they just know it all and offer you a certain outcome or whatever. So they will give you what you are looking for. They will give you what you want. They promise things that probably won't come true, things like that. And when do they pop up? When people are extremely sick or very obsessed or in love. So in life and death situations or in relationships that are heading towards divorce or when somebody left or things like that. These two situations are dangerous for people, whether or not you're a normal person or a healer or something, doesn't really matter. Then you are most vulnerable to be influenced or even attacked by these kind of fake spirits, guides or healers or trickster demons. And how do you recognize them? Like I said, it's often has to do with time, being exhausted after a healing or something, or after communication or connection. And what did I say? Sorry, I'm trying to really get this done. And they tell you what you want to hear or want to know. Whereas real ascended masters or an angel or a spirit guide or somebody who you love very much has passed away, an entity or whatever, even a tree or an oracle, often give you answers that you had no idea were possible or existed or that you simply don't agree with. And that's because they are high vibrational beings with a lot more knowledge and wisdom than we have. They know best, and it's often not the answer or outcome that we want to work towards or want to work with, or something that we don't like to hear, or something that we just didn't expect to be there. So, fake spirit guides are often attachments that attach themselves into your auric field and then influence you with these nasty messages that accelerate and activate fear, frustration, being anxious, nausea, dizziness, things like that. And it's not about demons as in the Key of Solomon, Goetia kind of demons. It's just demons, simple, low vibrational demons that like to dominate a conversation or manipulate a relationship into a certain way, or always come with promises that have to do with time and dates, and it's just nasty. So when somebody's sick or when somebody left somebody behind, and that person, it's all about frustration, desperation, being abandoned, loneliness, depression, things like that. That's what they like you to experience, because that's what they feed on and it gives them pleasure. They enjoy seeing you miserable with tears flowing through your out of your eyes and over your cheeks, and just rubbing your eyes all the time, and not being able to sleep, or not being able to wake up, or not being able to enjoy the rain or the sun or the wind or whatever. That's what they like. That's how they want you to feel. And if they make promises or give you certain answers that turn out to be not true, then they are like, yes, we fooled her or we fooled him, and now she's even more disappointed and more food. Yay, you're just a all-you-can-eat buffet for these tricksters and spirits. And the more desperate and frustrated and lonely and depressed you become, even suicidal, the happier they are. And that's why protection is so important. And that's why it's so important to always focus on being joyful and playful and be hopeful and full of good things. Because then these tricksters and demons and fake spirit guides will just disconnect from you or leave you and try find somebody else that is able to be tricked and is able to be made a fool of and is able to they want to see people miserable. The worse the better. Worse means more food, more life, more strength, more power, more things like that. So a short video, watch out, please watch out. If something is offered to you and it has to do with time and date, just get rid of it. It's probably not true. And you have to take a ritual bath or do some Reiki healing or something like that. Some candle meditation also works. And I think this is it. See you next time. Bye.